Hello. I'm Seema Dhar from Development Support Center, and we are working in MP and Gujarat. We have done some work in, we are implementing two projects in MP in Dhar and in Dhar district, or two talukas of Dhar district, and we have done some convergence of NREG with PIM program in MP, and here is the case of that convergence. So the ground is that there is a 19-103 medium and more than 4,000 major minor irrigation schemes in MP, and about 2.59 million hectares of irrigation is created till now. But the complete canal network includes head regulator, main canal, distributory canal, minor canals, and finch canal. The NVDA is responsible for all this irrigation, this PRM and irrigation work. And the thing is that the background for this case is that there is a lack of funds for maintenance, operation, and repair of the canal. And due to that, the canal is not repaired and not lined properly, so farmers are not getting water for irrigation. Only 3 out of 24 villages in the Jhopar project, farmers are getting water. And so they are suffering and they have dissatisfaction towards the irrigation scheme. So there is a mechanism developed to fetch the fund for repair and maintenance, and they have developed they have fetched the fund from NREGA. This is the DSA program measure. We are working in Manavar and Kukshi. We are implementing participatory irrigation management in two projects, Man and Jobal Irrigation Scheme. This is the canal. There are 8 WLs, 4 in each block, Manavar and Kukshi. And the study is based in the project area of Kukshi and Manavar blocks of Dhar district of Madhya Pradesh. We have studied 8 WLs where the convergence takes place. This is the snapshot of Man and Jobal irrigation project. The key issues are the Man and Jobal project canal released water in the year 2007-8 after completion of headwork and canal network. However, most of the canal, including main distributory and minor, were unlined and lead to high amount of water seepage. Only 1500 to 2000 hectare area had been irrigated against the design command area of 9800 hectares. And 15 kilometer of only the water is to 15 kilometers of 26 kilometers of canal, covering only 3 villages out of 24 villages. Irrigation canals are designed to cater up to 40 hectares irrigation area through one cusset water. There is no system below 40 hectares to convey water up to the last field. So absence of field channels resulted in inequitable water distribution among the farmers. Considering this, all the issues, the state has identified the need to develop the effective system for service delivery and irrigation management through 3 approaches. Earlier there is no PIM or not working PIM in Madhya Pradesh in these two projects. There is making irrigation water available to every farmer through field channels. Second is effective repair, operation and maintenance of existing canal network for optimum water delivery. And third is transferring rights of irrigation management to the farmers by introducing PIM involving competent NGOs in the process. This thing leads to many changes in policies and practices. The main thing happen is state government launches scheme of Sahasra Dhara to convert MG Narega funds with PM program. And through that, using that fund, construction of water courses and field channels from outlets of minor canal would be built. They along the scheme named Sahastradhara, and Sahastradhara will under the scheme, NREGA fund will be provided to build the canals and repair and maintenance of canals. And there are two and this is the implementation model of this scheme. The project preparation include participatory walkthrough, then finalization of proposal, making DPR and preparation of detailed project report, technical sanction and project approval and project sanction, and then implementation of project. This is Manan Jobat NREG Jobat Engineering Assisted Canal Reparation Project is a part of PIM project only by MPRLP, NVDA and DSC. The fund for physical intervention is supported through MG Narega only, and the project empowers the WUA. The main thing is that the WUA is empowered to implement the convergence between MNREGA and PIM. The project rehabilitation, the project empowers WUA as the implementing agency for canal rehabilitation work. The MNREGA funds from Janpad are directly transferred to WUA in the project. There are two main technical components of the project: the carrying out the canal repair maintenance program through desilting, earth leveling, repair, earth embankment, bank rising. All these things have been done under the MNREGA fund, using an MNREGA fund. And the other, carrying out construction of field channel water courses in command area are using the Sahastradhara fund. These are the work constructed under MNREGA. This is the role of a stakeholder in this convergent, how this convergent take place. Example of a GO-NGO and CBO partnership because of this convergence take place. MPRLP and MBDA is government agency, DSC is civil society organization, and WUAs are CBOs. So this is the partnership of GO-NGO and CBO. These are the roles and responsibility of three of them. The MPRLP and NVDA are looking after coordination, monitoring, intervention and fund mobilization. Then NVDA is technical and engineering agency. Janpad is funding support. And DSC is looking after technical support organization, knowledge-based support to MPRLP, especially for PIM. And the WAs are the implementing agency. There is a case study of Padiyal Jal Upbhokta Sansthan. WUA formed in June 2008. It comprised of 2,046 members across these 5 villages. And it is the physical, about 3,670 meters of field channels are constructed under this WUA with expenditure of 73 lakhs. And there the NREGA fund have been used. The administration of MNREGA funds are received by WUA from directly received by WUA from Jila Panchayat. Labor job with job cards are employed for rehabilitation work, and orientation is given to labor about the concept of the project, and what we have done is we employed the labor from this WUA only, and they have to work in proximity of their farms. So they have dignity of their labor because they are working for the canal which is coming to their farms only. So they basically they are working for themselves only. So they have dual benefit. They are getting labor and also they are getting water after building the canal. And Jhoka details and payment schedule is submitted to the Grameen Bank every week, 15 days. Payment is directly credited to the labor bank account. Normal duration of payment to labor is about 3 weeks. Rate of labor payment in most cases is done on a daily basis at the rate of 100 rupees per day. For transparency, details of physical work planning and expenses are shared once in Gram Sabha also. And the plan of canal rehabilitation in all the villages also shared with Gram Sabha. Major impacts of NREGA canal rehabilitation is the project has led to reduction in water seepage by about 50% because of lining, proper lining of canal. Increased irrigation network through field channels has, however, helped in local groundwater recharging. Farmers have observed an average 15 feet rise in the water table where field channels are constructed. Around 75% in the combined area are able to get water for irrigation post intervention. And project is being instrumental in increasing local employment, reduction in outward migration, reduction in debt in farmers' labor, and reduction in drudgery of fetching water. Some issues are also faced during this convergence happen. The WUA faced some practical issues with availability of labor, as the local interested labor had limited work days as per their job card. Moreover, they faced practical issues in actual expenditure of material and payment as compared to the scheduled budget. And the payment to labor took more than 3 weeks due to delay in preparation of job card and bank processing. So these are the issues. This is the story of a Sakuntala man who worked as labor in this canal rehabilitation work. She used to migrate from MP to Gujarat for agriculture work. But at the time of they need not to migrate, and somehow she is benefited from this. This is the another story of Ganbai Bank. This is the work under Sahasradhara, work done under the data of work done under Sahasradhara. And this is the canal rehabilitation work done under NREGA, using NREGA funds. The impact of project on community, substantial increase in groundwater table is seen where field channels are constructed, which has led to natural groundwater recharging and drinking water security. The irrigation security led to changes in cropping pattern. Majority of benefited farmers have been able to irrigate more than 50% of their land. Take a double crop, introduce cash crop like wheat, cotton, chili, introduce pulses and vegetable cultivation and cultivate 100% of their agricultural land. This has led to increase in annual agriculture income by 2-3 times, which which has lowered their debt, increased their assets and improved their social condition. NREDF has supported in generation of additional livelihood in the region. This has helped in controlling migration in the villages. Reduction in crime rates have also been noticed by the community due to meaningful employment in the region. And saving against power consumption for lifting water for irrigation and equity in irrigation water distribution have also been. The way forward is conversion is NREGA with irrigation activities of a great opportunity, ensuring better utilization of irrigation potential already created. And there is huge scope of extending NREGF canal reputation Sahasrara to other already irrigated and potential irrigable areas. And it should be scaled up as it should be the conversion should be scaled up in other states also, because there are lot 15 lakhs hectare canal network command areas are lacking the repair and maintenance fund in many states. So it is scalable. And the other states could also formulate schemes for using the funds or improving irrigation network by the WA, particularly in BCL and tribal dominant areas where adequate labor is available. And convergence of irrigation watershed drinking water projects can also work out to ensure balanced utilization of local, external external natural resources.
Thank you.